Super proud of all of you guys. To me, a lot of different guys stepped up tonight. A lot of different guys stepped up. Noah, I know you're a laboring man, and I know you're not 100%, but you went out there and ate some innings up, which we needed to get Grant to that end right there. So give Noah a round right there. Yeah. Yeah. I'm telling right now, listen, okay, I got to check myself as far as me getting intense and everything, but I'm telling you, regardless of who I put in that field, Chase, I put you in the field, you are one of our hardest workers, and you deserve to be on this field. You are one of us hardest workers. You never complain. So if anybody, give him a round, I'm telling you right now. I never hear you complain. And you put that ball in play right there into this. Rich, you kept moving. Grant, that was good heads up base running, man. What a finish to game, man. What a finish to game. That was awesome. Good stuff. Les, to take, to win the backyard brawl, 18 years, man, something to be proud of, man. Nobody will ever take that away from you guys right here. I am super proud of you, man. Let me see that thing real quick. Let me see that thing. Yeah. That's some good stuff. That's some good stuff right there. It's still all good. But listen, hey, super proud of you guys, all right? Rich, you came through, my man. You came through. Give Rich a round. Let me tell you, man. And in the first game of Lost Sox, sometime, then you got the big hit right there, and then you put pressure and use your speed right there. Nydick, where you at? Nydick, by you push button right there to get us counted. Get that in and start it. Nobody recognized the little things, but the baseball guys recognized the little things, what you did right there. So that was huge right there. Man, very proud of you. Very proud of you. Connor had a good series, my man. Good. And you were feeling better. You want to steal home. One day I'll let you.
Next time I'm on third coach. Hey, I'm telling you now.
Hey, well, let's get a picture right here. Hey, let's break it down to Ubuntu, and then we'll get a picture right here, and then we'll get out of here. Great job, guys.
2, 2, 1, 3, 1, 2, 3.
Had a baby, good.
Thank you, sir.
Here we go. Let's go.
I'm getting cut off here.
No, it's 12-6.
They just don't
have
the one.
They can't fit it. It's fine.
Just put up too many runs.
Hey, congrats.
Thank you.
This is our video, guys. We're going multi. What's the word?
Multimedia.
Multimedia. There you go. I'm a writer. I should know that. This has got to be a great feeling. Obviously, you guys have you want to do big things in the postseason, but to win the backyard brawl for the first time since 2003, what are the emotions like right now?
It's crazy. I remember playing here my freshman year, and just it hurt coming back, losing the championship to Sauk. It was great to get them first round, then play a great game here in the championship. It's awesome.
Do you feel like this kind of lets the area know how good you guys are to beat two perennial powers like Sauk and Montour?
Yeah, I just think it shows that we're gamers and we compete every play and never take a play off.
Did you guys, maybe come into this tournament with a chip on your shoulder thinking maybe people were thinking, maybe it's going to be Sauk and Montoursville and maybe overlooking you guys a little bit?
Yeah, it definitely fueled the fire a little bit, especially in that first game going against Sauk. They're a tough opponent always, and it's just great to compete against the rival schools.
I wanted to ask you about the first game, 1-0. Doesn't get a whole lot more thrilling than that as a pitcher. What was your mindset as the game wore on and you knew how precious that one run was?
Trust Coach Waller. I mean, he puts me in a position to win every time, and he puts me in a position to succeed. So I trust that man with my life, and I roll with what he says.
Did when you guys got the one run, did you feel like maybe that was enough the way you and I think Sam came in and closed it out, that maybe that would be enough, that you guys were feeling that good on the mound?
Yeah, I believed in the guys behind me. They play excellent defense when I'm on the mound, and I believed that we were going to get the job done, and we got the job done.
Well, you've been, he's used you in a lot of late game situations this year, and you get the call against Sauk. Do you kind of embrace those moments, having the ball in your hand in big games like that?
Yeah, I mean, it just feels good to get out there and start the game off, and it's always the dream to go out there and just crush it in the backyard brawl. So
this Does this give you guys a feel of what, you know, like a playoff type feel, since this was a tournament and there was a championship and, you know, obviously the rivalry's in there. Is this something that's going to help you guys now?
Yeah, I feel like just competition-wise, facing the best of the best in the area, that's going to prepare us for the teams down the road. Mm-hmm. And we just look to battle every time, every game, every pitch.
Yeah. It seems like there's not one guy doing it. You know, you feel like whoever's up there, whoever's pitching, whatever, somebody's going to come through for you guys?
Yeah, we have confidence. I mean, even the backup guys, they're always working their tail off at practice. They're doing whatever they can do to be as best as they can. And, you know, Chase Beck, he got the opportunity in the game, and he put one up in the air. Good things happen when we put the ball in play. Scored two runs. That's huge.
Yep, absolutely. Okay. Appreciate you talking to me.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Yep. Thank you.